All right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all ready for Southern Fried Saturday night? I am too. Let's start November rain. This first match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Your referee, David Weekly. Ladies and gentlemen, accompanied to the ring by the manager, Xander Seabolt, please welcome from parts unknown, the Grappler number 2, and he is one half of the Southern Fried Tag Team Champions.
Oh my, we are getting started a little bit early here. Grappler number 2 didn't even get a chance to make his way to the ring. John Johnson, Adam Vance here in our opening contest.
Man, I'll tell you what, a little bit of payback here from what happened at the last event. These guys waited and jumped Sonny and Sal on their way to a tag title victory. And Sonny Daze gives them a taste of their own medicine as the battle happens here at the ringside area.
Yeah, Grappler number 2 was on his way out. Sonny Daze gets him from right from behind. And right now the crowd here at the Boys and Girls Club of Monroe, Georgia, loving what they're seeing in this opening contest. One half of the former Southern Fried Tag Team Champions, Sonny Daze, getting a little measure of revenge, and it hasn't even started yet.
Oh, no, no doubt. The bell has not rung yet. Xander Seabolt with that ever-present tennis racket. Oh, man. Grappler number 2 heading chest first into the barricade here. And he is in a bad spot now, and Sonny is in his element right now, no doubt.
It has always been a brawl here between Happy Madness and the Grapplers, and right now, right into the rail goes Grappler number 2.
I think Sonny called his shot there, Babe Ruth style. He pointed towards the barricade. There you go. That's how you hit a barricade. He slams him right into it there, and he sends Grappler number 2 into the ring, and senior official David Weekly now in charge of this matchup. Might be calling for the bell. There we go. Absolutely there, and Sonny slides through the ropes, going at it there. Sonny heading in, Grappler number 2 off the ropes there, and a big knee lift right to the midsection into the breadbasket of Grappler number 2. And a second one as well.
You mentioned it was at our last event. That was Crossroads. Wait a minute, Sonny Daze in. Oh, crossbody.
Holy smokes, man, what a impact there. Holy smokes.
You mentioned our last event. That was Crossroads. Yeah, that night we saw the Grapplers sneak attack Sonny on his way out to the ring. But more importantly, what we saw was the Grapplers become the new Southern Fried Tag Team Champions, ending the third reign of Happy Madness. Right now, Sonny Daze just taking his time inside the ring. Maybe not wise, because we don't know much about the experience of the Grapplers. We don't know how long they've been in wrestling. We don't know anything about them.
No, not at all.
Other than that, Xander Seabolt's their manager.
Oh, exactly there. You know, we just, it's a, Xander's checking on his man there at ringside, checking to make sure he's all right to continue in this matchup. And he goes under and breaks the count there. Smart move as he's trying to gather himself here outside the ring.
But he's getting a lot of time to catch his breath. This is going to be a lot different than a second win. This is basically going to be a reset of this matchup. Once we get the Grappler in the ring, I mean, he's going to have a chance to recover from a lot of that damage.
You're right there, too. And don't forget, these are two tag team wrestlers in a singles match here tonight. So conditioning and making sure this match ends quickly is going to be to either one of these guys' advantage, because they're not going to be out here for 20 minutes, I don't think, wrestling this matchup.
Right now you see Grappler number two finally in the ring, getting in the face of Sunny Days. Oh,
Grappler there with an eye poke as Sunny turned, and Grappler number two starting some offense there.
Yeah, he suckered Sunny Days in and then poked him in the eye. And right now goes right back to that eye.
Another one. We need somebody needs to work out some Southern Fried goggles. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar style. Maybe we might have, that might be a really dated reference. Anyway, so, the Grappler's there, old school, going for a slam. Grappler number two not able to pick up Sonny, and Sonny just plants him with that nasty headbutt, whiplash style, right to the chest of the Grappler. And up on the apron now is Xander Seabolt. He's getting the attention of Sunny Days, and Sunny has him. Hold on, here's a Grappler. Oh, what? There's another Grappler coming from the back down. He lands in the ring. Seabolt had a plan, it looks like. Sonny's going to pin him. Weekly doesn't know it's him. Holy crap. Weekly doesn't realize the Grappler's changed. And Seabolt now. Oh, jeez. Holy
Sunny
hell.
Days.
Seabolt just plastered Sonny with that tennis racket right in the back. And now the Grapplers are going at it.
Hold on here.
Oh, that's Todd Sexton.
That's not a Grappler. That's a technician. And it's Todd Sexton in the ring.
And Sexton now. Seabolt's backing off there. Sonny's in the corner. Sexton has that tennis racket, and he hits Seabolt with it.
I think Sonny's just as shocked as the rest of us.
What on earth? Sonny's picked up Todd, and he's celebrating there in the ring with the Sour Naro style. Sonny realizes what happened. I don't even think he knew that happened. Todd Sexton's asking for the microphone. Let's see what this young man has to say. He's retired.
So I like lead the team for like 2 minutes and you lose the belts. What happened? Sal's not here. I'm grappling number 0.0. So for about a year now, Seabolt, you've been coming out here trying to cosplay with a little tennis racket and stuff. So Thanksgiving night, what about myself, Sonny, and Sal take on the Grapplers and you in a six-person tag team match? You said no? You said no? No? No. Hold on. Hold on. Okay. Let's ask Mr. Manders. Yes or no? We'll see you guys Thanksgiving night.